I'm taking the branch line east to Whittlesey. Relying on the constituents of what Bradshaw's dismissed as its boggy ground, since the 1880s, Peterborough and its surrounds have built a prosperity based on the manufacture of a construction product that most of us take for granted. Bricks. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, so much of our capital city was built with these that the product became known simply as London Brick. I'm in Whittlesey to meet David Weeks, whose company bought the original London Brick Company in the 1980s.
So this wonderful stuff is clay, is it?
Yeah, this is really the heart of the whole process. It's called Lower Oxford clay, and interestingly, when the brickworks first started in Peterborough, they used the very soft clay on the top. And a guy called James Craig, who had set up the first brickworks, discovered this much harder clay underneath, and purely by chance, as they dug further and further. And there's a rich seam now, goes from Oxford all the way up to Yorkshire, and all these brickworks were sited along the seam of clay.
With its high carbon content, Lower Oxford clay had a unique property. It was combustible, so less fuel was needed to fire the bricks in the production process. In the late 19th century, this industry was able to save energy and to make use of a raw material that was both natural and plentiful.
There's been quarry around this part of Peterborough for over 100 years now. This is the last working clay quarry, and when this is finished, it will be the end of an era, because the market for these bricks is gradually tailing off, because although they're very hard-wearing and durable, they don't have the insulation properties of a modern brick.
By the 1930s, the market for London bricks was huge. And most of the Peterborough brickyards had their own railway sidings to transport their finished products. David wants to show me how the very finest London bricks are produced.
So tell me about this process here.
Well, at the back you can see the what we call the green bricks, which are just the natural clay as it's come out of after the bricks have been pressed. This is one of the kiln chambers. They've been put in the kiln chamber ready to be fired, and these guys are now bricking it up with old reject bricks, and they will then seal it with a render, and then gradually the fire will work its way round into this chamber and fire these bricks and move on to the next chamber.
How long will your green bricks stay there until they're proper bricks?
They'll be in the kiln for about 5 days.
To ensure that the enormous kiln is working to maximum capacity, it's been given handy portholes to add fuel.
Oh, wow. That is a brilliant sight, isn't it? Those are glowing bricks, are they?
Yeah. 1,000 degrees.
Oh, yeah, so that's quite nice on a cold day.
The process starts with them, as they approach the fire, they gradually dry out, and then the temperature rises up to 1,000 degrees where they fire properly, and then there's a process, then they cool down, and the whole cycle takes about 12 days. And the fire moves around the kiln, the bricks are scattered all the time, the fire tracks its way around, and we load the green bricks in ahead of the fire, and then take out the fired bricks behind the fire. It's a continuous process.
Once fired and cooled, even in today's mechanised world, London bricks are packed the old-fashioned way, by hand.
Oh, dear boy, would you like to do the hand?
Always one for a challenge. What do I have to do?
Put them on there, just make sure that they... Hold the fingers, because they bite.
They bite, do they? I don't think it's got speed, isn't it? Did you do this all day, do you, Rich?
All day, yeah.
Goodness. Did you do any of the other jobs around the brickworks?
No, not really, no.
This is what you
do. We have done them, but this is our main job.
So, makes it pretty tough.
Yeah, it's sad, but at the end of the day. And plus, we just come back on holiday, so...
So you're a little bit out of practice?
Stiff, yeah, at the minute, yeah.
Many thousands have put in shifts at London Brick, some of them from surprising backgrounds. After the Second World War, Britain's cities had to be rebuilt and the demand for bricks soared. The London Brick Company employed more than 3,000 prisoners of war, but But after they went home in the early 1950s, London Brick began a recruitment drive in southern Italy. As a result, Peterborough has a thriving Italian expat community.
What did you come to do? You didn't come to work in a brick factory.
No, Dad, I just come for my love, my husband.
And what did he do?
Work in a London brick company.
In the London brick company.
What better way to end a journey than to be immersed in a vibrant community built brick by brick?